W-E-F-U-N-K. We funk.
So I guess those are really, again, just some of the endless action going down in March in New York City. And again, I guess I should give a quick apology to any of the Jammin' World, any of the Big LW podcasters that are outside the New York City area and have wasted their the last hour listening to this shit about a bunch of shows they're never going to be able to see because they're dedicated Big LW fans. However, they live in Nova Scotia, Halifax, and live vicariously through my upcoming posts on my book and on the cloud and in the tube for reviews of the action. But I guess what I want to do now on the show, all right, is if you didn't believe me already by everything I've told you, if you didn't believe me that it was an epic month to be a music fan in New York City, what I am gonna do now is I am gonna take you through a daily music schedule in the month of March if you're a true music fan in New York City. All right. So I guess if you're not willing to show the proper dedication to your music enjoyment and attend 29 of the next 31 concerts, don't even bother listening to the just shut your computer off now, and I don't want you as a listener if you're not willing to attend at least one major concert in New York City every day for the month of March. So I am going to now quickly run through the entire month of March with your concert schedule. And I guess it would only be appropriate to let the Allman Brothers help us along. A little musical accompaniment as we take you through the month of March. And of course, I guess from the famed Allman Brothers Fillmore East of 71, recorded in March, as all the way dating back to the early 70s, the Allman Brothers have been kicking the shit out of March. And this Elizabeth Reed recorded about 1 week and 49 years and about 40 blocks south of where I'm standing right now. And so we will let the Allman Brothers help set the soundtrack for our month of March, which of course kicked off on Sunday night the 1st with Widespread Panic playing one of the illest shows at the Beacon. All right, a one-armed Steve, a ribs and whiskey, a second set disco diner with your boy Big LW in the building. Right, a Lou Reed Ain't Life Grand encore that literally almost blew the circuits at the legendary Beacon. And on Monday the 2nd, let's do it again. I guess potentially a little anticlimactic, I would have to imagine, after the absolute rager that was Sunday. It's hard to imagine that Monday could do it again, however, and I Wanna Be Sedated, Ramones opener in New York City ain't a bad way to kick it off. A Love Tractor and a Pigeons, as well as a double Talking Heads encore in New York City, still left on tap to close down the 5 nights of Widespread Panic at the Beacon to kick off March. Right. I guess the 3rd, little bit of a quiet before the storm as we stay home and watch Mike Gordon and John Fishman with the Mallet Brothers on a live webcast from the Bernie Sanders campaign rally. Right. However, like I mentioned, quiet before the live music storm, as on the 4th, We're at Macy Gray at the Brooklyn Bowl. All right. The fifth, how about the Terrapin Family Band? All right. However, if you've seen them one too many times, maybe we check out this young sister named Celine Dion at the Barclays. All right. The sixth, how about we got Fabulous at the Apollo? The F-A-B-O at the Apollo. Or as well, a Crosstown Classic Festival conundrum. Do you see Fabo at the Apollo? Or the Millennium Tour with Bow Wow, Ashanti, and Soulja Boy at the Hulu? All right. The seventh, we check out Dweezil at the Paramount, or perhaps Melvin Seals at the Cap, two Jammin' World faves. All right. On the eighth, however, we check out the Allman Brothers store, pop-up store in Chelsea, 1 weekend only ahead of the Epic Brothers reunion. Get yourself some rare posters and cool concert tees. All right. On the 9th, of course, we celebrate the Notorious D.A.Y. by reflecting about how much Biggie kicked ass by jamming out to an ill Big L.W. playlist. All right. The 10th, we go see the brothers at the Garden. 11th, we check out the hilarious fish symposium at NYU, and then a post party with Papa Dosio. 12th, we got Love Rocks New York City at the Beacon. The 13th, we kick off Phil's birthday celebration. All right. Or on the 13th, maybe you check out Nathaniel Rateliff at Town Hall, or potentially the Soul Rebels with special guest DMX. Saturday, another Phil birthday celebration at the Cap. Or you jet down to Nashville to check out Brooklyn Bowl South. An opening weekend, opening night, rather, of the Brooklyn Bowl Nashville. However, your boy Big LW will be sitting right at the Hulu watching Jersey's own Shakur Stevenson fearlessly defend the featherweight strap. All right, however, on the 15th, happy birthday to my man Phil Lesh by standing on the GA floor of the Cap, watching the candles blow out as we all sing happy birthday, hopefully with the Box of Rain encore. If you've already seen Phil twice, maybe you check out the sensation that is Billie Eilish at Madison Square Garden, or the Styx at the Beacon, or the Dead Kennedys at the Brooklyn Bowl. However, definitely would suggest Dead Kennedys at the Brooklyn Bowl in lieu of Phil's birthday. However, on the 16th, we go to MOP at Sunny Hall, or you get some early St. Paddy's Day in with the Wolf Tones at Connolly's, a bar gig for one of the most legendary Irish folk bands of all time, huh? And then on Tuesday the 17th, we celebrate St. Patrick's Day, of course, with the Big LW St. Paddy's Day playlist, all right, as well as a couple of posts about the Irish influence on music and boxing. But I guess around New York City, you can go see a legendary Irish rockers, House of Pain, at Sony Hall. How about legendary Irish rockers, the Chieftains, with original leader Paddy Maloney. Literally nothing is more St. Paddy's than Paddy Maloney leading the Chieftains in Town Hall in New York City after 11 hours of Guinnesses with cops on the parade. But I guess if you're not in New York, you could very well be in Boston at the Dropkick Murphys annual residency, which did include, by the way, this year again, the Saturday night Dropkick Murphy boxing blowout, where boxing in the day, Dropkick Murphy's concert at night, at the House of Blues in Beantown. So check it out if you're one of my New England jammers, all right? Or, of course, other classic Celtic punk band, Flogging Molly, at their true home in Los Angeles at the Palladium. Not at Molly's, but at the Palladium. To celebrate a St. Patrick's Day. And I guess we will wake up on the 18th with quite the hangover from alcohol and excitement after 17 consecutive days of pretty major live concerts. Right. So we will just have a casual Wednesday of Gatorade and marijuana to cure our hangover. But on the 19th, we'll be at it again. back to the garden for Billy Joel, and the piano man will sing us a song. On the 20th, we wake up, like I spoke of before, but we wake up to a psychedelic webcast of Umphrey's in Iceland at the Northern Lights. So a pretty sick webcast, I'm assuming, will be taking place the morning of the 20th. With nighttime, we go to Brooklyn, because we missed her at the garden for Phil's birthday, but I gotta check out this Billie Eilish chick before her 5 minutes is up. However, I will probably, however, be at Antibolus at the Brooklyn Bowl, alright, on the eve of Brooklyn Comes Alive, where I will find out what the hell Avant Gardner is. Or at nighttime, you can check the Revivalists at Radio City Music Hall. Right. Sunday the 22nd, we got Lisa Loeb at LPR, or Lupe Fiasco at Brooklyn Steel. All right. The 23rd, I go to Riverdance with my grandma. All right. And the 24th, you go to Mandy Moore at the Beacon Theater. The 25th, from Mandy Moore to Thundercat at Webster. On the 25th, ahead of the Mets opener, the next day, you will hang out at Citi Field in the afternoon before evening shows from the Dirty Knobs at the Brooklyn Bowl, or a pretty epic booking for Sirius XM listeners, Pearl Jam at the legendary Apollo Uptown. Couple of weeks after Fabulous, Pearl Jam will get their chance to shred the Apollo in XM puts on those shows at the Apollo that are always super intimate and cool, and then released on the radio. So get your chance to hear Pearl Jam, just like Metallica and Paul McCartney and Bruce and others that have played the Apollo for XM. All right. The 27th, however, we go to Bisco at the Cap and Bring the Mall. All right. The 28th, Third Eye Blind at Radio City Music Hall. Saturday the 29th, you check out Gwar at St. Vitus. Or potentially the last of 12 for the Bad Plus at the Vanguard, with your boy Big LW in attendance, I'm sure, for the late show on a Sunday to close down the Bad Plus residency. All right. The 30th, Pearl Jam at Madison Square Garden, ending the month the day after on the 31st with Tom York from Radiohead at the Hammerstein Ballroom, one of New York City's super intimate and really, really legendary, historic, however oft used, right, as rarely epic bookings like Tom York going down at the Hammerstein, unfortunately, in 2020 anyway, but a super cool booking there from the PJ at Apollo category, Tom York at Hammerstein, as well as Action Bronson at the Brooklyn Bowl and Milhaly at the Bowery to close down your month of March, which of course included Chuck Leavell sitting in live with Derek Warren and O'Teal on an epic Jessica, and so much more fun going down across the whole city in the month of March, across all the genres, across all the neighborhoods, across all the venues. It is all going down in New York City in March.
Big Al!
WEFUNK. We Funk.